Sam Carmichael. Bill Austin. And Harry Bright.
You're a dog on base!
over in these stinking stilettos.
Well, what did you expect? Chauffeured limousine at the water's edge?
Yes. Donna knows I don't do walking.
Cornelia, how are you? How's the sun? I heard he's getting pretty old. Hi. Oh, you're doing great. Thank you so much. Well, you look what the time washed in.
For one night and one night only,
Donna and the Dynamos!
Woo! So, how's the mother of the bride?
Much better for seeing the likes of you two. God, Tanya, 8 freaking years!
I know, honey, I'm sorry. It's just been one jet-setting millionaire after another.
Oh, I know. And I've been chained to this place. The constant battles with the bank manager.
I pity the poor bank manager.
Sophie Sheridan, you get more gorgeous every time I see you.
Don't I get a big fat hug? I'll come all this way for your wedding.
I bet you don't remember me.
All that plastic surgery.
Of course I do. Auntie Tanya. Will you look at my baby? Her whole life ahead of her.
Mom, getting married, not joining a convent.
I know. Well, in my day, you didn't just get married at 20.
Donna, in our day, we didn't get married, period.
A white wedding. Can you believe this? I don't know what has gotten into her head.
Don't blame me, Donna. It wasn't my idea.
Ladies, meet the leading man at tomorrow's shindig. Skye, this is Rosie and Tanya, my one-time backup band and all-time best pals.
Backup band my foot. Hello.
Hi. I've heard lots about you two.
All bad, I hope.
You say cook in the posse setting.
If Hadi starts a pota.
Don't mind him. He doesn't speak Greek. My name is Eddie. Bonjour, mademoiselle.
Bonjour, Eddie. Enchanté de faire votre connaissance.
Bon appétit.
Well, they call me Pepper.
Why? Because you're off?
No, because he gets up your nose.
Tanya, meet Pepper and Eddie. My boatmen, waiters, and general help. Only they're generally no help at all. Don't you two have any work you should be doing?
Honey, the taverna looks fabulous.
You've got Skye to thank for that.
Why, what have you been up to?
You haven't been here that long, have you?
No. I took a break from stocks and bonds and never went back.
Why?
I'd had enough. See, I've been dealing in the world, but I'd never seen the world.
Well, you should see what he's done to my world. He's got me online, emailed, wired up, and knuckled down.
You have to move the time zone. And more drachmas under the mattress.
You just invent me a machine that'll make the beds.
And if they did, you'd be going along behind them, making them again. I know you, Mom.
I'll be more than ready to put my feet up when my boat comes in.
Speaking of boats, I'd sink that old wreck you've got moored by the jetty.
Sink it?
Well, it's a bit of an eyesore.
That eyesore is going to be my floating casino.
What?
Skye and Eddie are transforming it into a millionaire's paradise.
Sailing around the islands, gambling into the stars.
Gambling millionaires. Maybe a few of your old husbands aboard, Tanya.
Oh, I don't think so, honey. I spent their millions.
Well, girls, this is my jackpot. I need a break. I need a vacation. I've been running this hotel for 15 years, and I've never had a day off.
I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay.
Ain't it sad?
And still there never seems to be a single penny left for me.
Bless you, God.
In my dreams, I have a plan. If I got me a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work at all. I'd fool around and have a ball.
It's a rich man's world.
Ooh, 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 ooh. if he happens to be free, I bet he wouldn't fancy me.
That's too bad.
Is that a quote?
Oh, I know this guitar. HB, Ed Bang. That's what they used to call me in those days. And Diaz, Donna Sheridan. I bought this for it. Take away my Johnny Rock t-shirt. Now who says I'm an unadventurous old stick in the mud?
Ew.
My other half. A big house, a fast car, and a season ticket to the Chelsea Football Club isn't enough for some people, is it? They want the Great White Hunter, too. Well, I could do spontaneity. That's why I'm here. Donna knew my wild side. I was an exchange student in Paris when we met, and I just followed her to Greece. Spontaneously. We used to sing this one.
Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy that they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty. What will life be without a song or dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
You're Donna's daughter?
Yes.
Wow. I thought you looked familiar. Sophie. Sophia!
It's just Sophie.
No, Sophia's the Greek. How to greet Sophia.
I'm named after Sophia.
Where's Donna? I need to see her. Thank her for the invitation.
Yeah, it's very kind of her to remember us.
Well, you can't. You're a secret. I sent the invitations. Mom doesn't know.
Why?
Because Mom's always talking about her friends from the old days, and I thought she'd be thrilled if I invited you all. But she's got herself in such a state about this wedding. Mention unexpected guests, and she'll hyperventilate.
Sophie, are you trying to tell me that you're the one who sent the invitation?
Yes. So pretend you're here on holiday. She'll get a lovely surprise when she sees you at my wedding, and we'll let her in on the secret.
Sophie.
Mother says I was a dancer before I could walk.
Boy, have you made a mistake.
She says I began to sing long before I could talk. But I often wonder, how did it all start? Who found out?
The last time I saw your mother, she told me that she never wanted to see me again. So, if you're the one who sent the invitations, I'm still banned.
But that was years ago. I want you here.
Why?
Because it's my wedding, and I want us all to be friends.
You're just a little minx. You're worse than your mother. God, I'm glad you haven't met my boys.
Your boys? Your sons?
Yeah, two. God, I'd love to bring them here someday.
Like used to bring my mother? I've been so lucky. I am the girl with golden hair. I want to sing it out to everybody. What a joy, what a life, what a chance.
Thank you for the music, the song. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can-
trouser press on the island?
I'll show you to your rooms.
Answer.
There was something in the air that night. Fernando. They were shining bright for you and me so easily, Fernando. Though we never thought that we.
Donna!
Bill Austin?
Donna!
Harry Headbanger?
I.
You!
Here I go again.
Blow, don't suck.
How the heartaches come and they grow and the scars they leave.
her dad.
Who's that?
Sophie's. You know how I always said it was Sam, the architect who went home to get married?
I'm so typical man.
Well, I'm not really sure if it were him. You see, there were a couple of others.
Donna Sheridan, you dark horse. Why didn't you tell us?
I didn't think I'd ever have to. I didn't think all three would be sitting in my bar the day before their daughter's wedding.
What? In the bar?
Don't let them see you.
I can't see anyone. Who are they?
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. You think I could forget my daughter's dads? It's Bill Austin, Sam Carmichael, Harry Headbanger.
Not?
How does it happen like this? It's like some sort of horrible fate.
It's very Greek. Do they know?
They can't know. I never told anyone. Why are they here to ruin Sophie's wedding?
I thought you weren't keen on this wedding.
I don't want them spoiling it. What the hell have they ever done for their daughter?
Donna, be fair. They didn't know she existed.
And they don't need to know. I've done a damn good job with Soap all by myself. And now I'm about to be muscled out by an ejaculation.
No, you're not. Keep calm. You're safe this evening. It's a male-free zone at Sophie's party. And tomorrow, Tanya and I will take them fishing. Fishing?
Oh, please.
What do you expect me to do with three men?
Now that takes me back.
You should have told us.
I remember Bill Austin. He was a hot slice of beefcake.
Oh, sure. It's a laugh and a memory to you two, but I was the one who got pregnant. I guess this just about serves me right.
Oh my God, you sound just like your mother.
I do not.
Yes, you do. Whatever happened to our Donna, life and soul of the party, El Rock Chick Supremo?
She grew up, that's all.
Well, grow back down again. You haven't done anything to be ashamed of.
Yeah, screw them if they can't take a joke.
Thank you.
You guys haven't told me yet, but there are lap dancers at the Orpheus Bar, mud wrestling at Medusa's, and Pepper bringing his handcuffs.
Don't go!
What? Miss out on my last night of freedom?
No, I don't mean don't go. I mean, is that really how you see it?
Yeah. No, look. All right. I see it as the last night before the biggest adventure of my life. Come here.
You know how I said I wanted to find my father?
Sophie, we've been through this 1,000 times. You don't need your dad. I'm here.
Sorry. If that ever happens, you'll never leave me. Will you?
Are you crazy? You've turned my world upside down. I wasn't jealous before we met. Now every man that I see is a potential threat. And I'm possessive, it isn't nice. You heard me say that smoking was my only vice. Now it isn't true. Now everything's new. And all I've learned is overturned. I beg of you.
Thank you.
doing here?
Hey, at night, women only.
No, we want the guys to stay, don't we, girls?
Regretting not knowing what was here.
What?
This place, the Taverna. I always meant to come back and build it someday, but your mom, she beat me to it.
Do you always prefer buildings to people?
What?
Tell me something about my mom.
Your mom was irresistible, a one of a kind. We talked and we fought and we... You know, it was me who brought her to this island.
Well, that wasn't the only thing you did, was it?
What has she told you?
Well, nothing. She's never mentioned you.
But you said that your mom's always talking about her friends from the olden days. What's going on, Sophie? Why am I here?
No, I haven't put myself on the path to certainty.
Well, it's never too late.
I don't think my other half would agree.
Oh, you don't want children.
No, it's not that. I like a daughter. I was spoiled her to bits.
Lucky thing.
Is your dad here?
I don't know.
What?
I don't know who my dad is.
I'm a writer, so I go to the territory.
Go on!
How did your mother get this place? Well, not to worry, she was a singer at a nightclub in the mainland.
She had left money and a will. We lived with an old lady when I was little. Mom looked after her. Her name was Sophia.
My great aunt Sophia.
Well, I think it must be.
But I always heard her money went to family. Wait a minute. How old are you?
20!
Thank you.
trust me, I'm doing what's right. I didn't mean to lie.
Thank you.